Hello everyone, assalamualaikum. So here we'll talk about how to use ID with GetBuilder if you use Getx. Now, as you know that GetBuilder takes the controller type, so here in our controller type is questions controller, and here I have this ID. Now, this question controller is this one. Now, since this GetBuilder is wrapping a widget, now we know that we have to have update method. So here is our update method. And inside this method, so here we have this update method inside this method. Now here we see that we do have this ID. This ID actually refers to this part of this GetBuilder, because you may use GetBuilder in many different places with the same controller with many different widgets. But if you trigger update, all those widgets at the same time would get rebuilt, and you don't want to do that because that's very expensive and there is no point of doing that. So if you have an ID attached to it, and wherever the GetBuilder is for that ID, that certain widget gets revealed, but not all the widgets that's using GetBuilder and that certain controller. Now over here, I'm using GetBuilder inside this UI and the same controller. And of course, this is a different widget on different UI. Now, to prevent revealed across every widget, so we have another ID over here. So this is a new ID, which is different than the earlier ID. Now, over here, all I need to do, I need to inject this or put this new ID inside this, and we are good to go. All right, so with this, whenever I reveal this widget, it won't conflict and update over here. So if you use different widgets with the same GetBuilder and same controller, then you should have ID, which is very efficient for memory and your app speed.